In this video, we're going to attempt to implement sequence-to-sequence sentence boundary detection using the OpenAI API and Fuchsia translation. So as you can see here, Fuchsia translation is already implemented. For Fuchsia translation, what we do is we pass this text to the language model. So this is Fuchsia because we give it two prior examples of doing a translation with this structure here. So translate to French from English, and then an example of translating to French from English, similar to Russian from German. And then this generates our text. So as you can see, it's not working especially well, at least for this case. So what I'm going to try to do is split the input text into sentences using sequence-to-sequence sentence boundary detection, and then translate each sentence individually using Fuchsia translation. This has a couple of advantages. One, it should make it a little easier on the language model and hopefully avoid this. Also, I'll be able to use a weaker model from the OpenAI API, which should reduce costs. And for AI safety reasons, OpenAI prefers only outputting smaller snippets of text when possible. So sequence-to-sequence sentence boundary detection is doing this. So we have this special token here, and then we pass it some piece of text to be split into sentences, and then hopefully the language model will generate a sentence boundary token to indicate where the sentence boundary is. This is already implemented for OpenNMT. We have models trained that do this. So now we want to do it Fuchsia using the OpenNMT API. So I'm just running Argos Translate. I set the model provider to OpenAI, and then I gave it my OpenAI API key. So let's get started. Okay, so this is what it's using. Okay. Okay, I think we want a new thing to generate the prompt. I'll do this up here. And okay. Okay. And then we'll probably have to refactor this. So once it comes back, it'll probably have this, and we'll need to move that at the end. So split okay, so that works. So for now, I guess we can just do the second to last one, assuming there's one at the end, and then the second line of that. Okay. Def spawns. equals const text split. Less than 2 Well, it should be at least 3 Oh, no. No, because we won't get the prompt back. So it should be at least 2 because we're assuming the last one is a new line. So this is going to be, we're assuming this is 2 lines, and then we want to cut off the token, -1 and then find Okay, that seems reasonable. So I think we should do this refactor. The text, SPD translation, sentence guess. Okay. So we don't need to do... I guess we still need to do this. And then this is replaced. I just don't want to duplicate this logic of tying it back to the original string. So I think I can just factor that out. Dev. Process. D. Input text. And then. Guess. So maybe I shouldn't do this part. Turn. Okay. Okay, so SVD translated, yes. Okay. Input text. Guess. Okay. Okay. Okay, so first we need to split into sentences here. So we should already have the language model, which just says this interface. Okay. Split into sentences. Okay. Sentence guess length. Is this done? The text sentence. Oh, yeah. So I don't want to duplicate this, but it's going to be decently different. Okay. Sentences start index. This. Tag sentence index. This is what's different. is the general few shot SPD prompt input text so then it wants an index back. Spans equals okay, and then this will return the index. So detected sentence index goes SVD dot process sequence to sequence. SVD text start index Fuchsia response. Oh, I want to do that too. So this should be the response with the token, and then we want to find the index of it. And Okay, so hopefully this works. Sentences. So I guess we can give this a try. Okay. Screen SPD. Prompt is not defined. Okay. Runtime object has no attribute. Okay. So I'm assuming that means this happened. Non-type object. So I'm assuming it's one of these. So we should add login. Okay. So this is the actual one. This is what's coming back. Let's make sure we're querying it right. Okay, so that seems pretty reasonable. So this is what's coming back. Text to translate. So it's not adding the token, is the issue. And then that's cascades to the none. Okay. So OpenAI is just not detecting sentence boundaries. We could give it more examples. This seems pretty clear. I'm surprised it didn't figure as much more difficult things out. Yeah, let's try another one. Okay, so now there's three examples. Okay. Here's our example. This looks right. Maybe just because this isn't a real sentence. If we give it something better. Output. Oh, it made up this token. Output punctuation. Word join. Online. Okay, yeah, so let's give it a real sentence. Okay. Did something. Oh wow, we did some sort of sentence boundary detection. Oh, so it didn't fail because it did come up with the token, but in some like totally different text. So the OpenAI few shot sentence boundary detection is working worse than OpenNMT with a custom trained model. So maybe the thing to do is to use the OpenNMT model to do sentence boundary detection for OpenAI, which probably still has higher quality sentence translation. I'm gonna have to think about this though. All right.